So what I've come here today to do is difficult for me. What I've come here to do today is to ask you for help. You see, when my mother was 11 years old, she had her usual fight with her father in the morning on her way to school. She came home later that afternoon to find him in the garage, hanging. He had taken his own life. Show of hands, how many people in here have been touched by a suicide, attempted suicide, or know somebody that has been touched by this difficult to understand situation for most of us? Let me not read you some statistics from my card. In the United States, it's the 10th leading cause of preventable death. Globally, it's the 3rd leading cause of death of men between the ages of 14 and 44. And in the last 45 years, it is up 65%. In the last 45 years, in this time, a time such as this, where we have seen technical innovation, like unbelievable innovations. We've gone from cave walls, it seems, to printers in everybody's homes. But what I'm here for is to ask you for your help. That at a time such as this, where we can connect the way we can connect instantly and globally, and yet this is on the rise. I know I'm looking at a room full of people that can turn this around. I've only got part of the solution. You've only got part of the solution, but when we work together, we can do something about this. It's up to us. It's our turn. Let's get mental health and learning and leading on the same curve as technical innovation. Let's bring it to the forefront of our society so that we can deal with this. I thank you.
James, you brought your frying pan out and you cooked it. Let me tell you something up in here, my brother.
I love your conviction. I love your theme. One of the goals I have is training 100,000 voices of hope, everyday people, outside of religion, outside of politics. Politicians tell you to do what I tell you to do, and I give you a piece of American pie. Religious leaders say, do what I tell you to do, and I teach you how you live after you die. I want ordinary people learning to do 3 things. One, give people hope, because when there's hope in the future, they give you power in the present. 2, teach people techniques and strategies on how to control their destiny and finding a life of purpose. And 4, create communities, and as you said, in technology, create communities of collaborative, achievement-driven, supportive relationships that will allow them to be able to live a life of meaning. I love what you do, I love your conviction, and I'm looking forward to working with you. Thank you so much.